Right, the red lipstick murder. So this is our first case on the homicide desk. It's bound to be a tricky one. More trickier than, you know, traffic. Brutal.
All right, gentlemen, take your seats. Let's get this over before lunch. Clyde Rose of the homicide squad has decided to take early retirement. We will all miss Floyd and the steely edge he brought to his police work. The department has arranged a wee drink at the Galway Arms to quench the mighty thirst a man gets from 25 years of police work. Floyd's departure leaves a place at the top table. And the chief has seen fit to promote Cole Phelps from burglary to the homicide desk. Stand up, Phelps. Take a chair. You're in the major leagues now, Sonny. Rusty Galloway, a fine lawman of the old school, will be taking you under his wing. Your first case is the murder of a woman found last night and bearing all the signs of the werewolf. Get out to the scene, lads.
I would have liked to have done the burglary desk. I thought that would have been interesting. But we're straight from traffic to murder. For us, anyway.
Do you have the address?
It's been all over KGPL. It's off Temple Street, between Belmont and Glendale.
Do we get a new car now and a new desk? Looks like it.
Phelps!
What happened to Rose?
Parker wants the chief's job. Word is it's either going to be him or Thad Green. So they're both clearing the decks.
Where does that leave you, Galloway?
Leaves me saddled with a chump like you, Phelps. I didn't ask for you, and I don't want you, so keep it to yourself. See if you can learn something about seeing how a real cop operates.
What did he mean by the werewolf?
Hey!
Oopsie-daisy.
Medallion. The Daily News came out calling him the werewolf killer. The Examiner came up with the black...
Easy!
I kind of killed somebody's car there. Sorry. Guess my car's tougher than
theirs.
Any closer
to catching him?
Not a chance. 6 months and hundreds of guys running down leads, we got nothing.
You don't think this has anything to do with it?
No, I don't. 90% of murders are domestic, Phelps. Some guy gets into a beef with his wife, he takes it too far. This will be the same. But cutting someone in half and leaving them off the sidewalk, that's a one-off.
Why is somebody winning this year?
Because of the war. You should know that. Guy gets to kill people every day in combat. Comes home, he's expected to take lip from his wife. What do you think's gonna happen?
It's that simple.
Just out the dirt.
Like I said, most of the time it is.
I don't think this one's going to be that simple.
How about a scoop for the Examiner, Galloway? You could use some good press.
Another tramp, another message. Is the werewolf back in business, boys?
Do you have a mother, asshole? A sister? How about showing some respect for this poor woman? Let us do our job, and Detective Galloway will give you a statement later.
He's good, Rusty. He even sounds genuine.
That's Phelps, guys. The war hero. Defending the honor of murdered humps.
They're used to it, Phelps. Moving along, guys. You got your pictures, you got your headlines. Now scram.
Well, that's a bloody mess. Plenty of footprints around as well.
Patrolman, this your beat?
Yes, sir. Well, part of it. Kids park here, they use it like a lover's lane. It's a working neighborhood. Some trouble, but nothing like this. It's known locally as the Moors.
You were first on the scene?
Yes, Detective.
No one's disturbed the body?
No, sir. We cleared out them vulture reporters so Pinker in the corner could work. They're waiting to talk to you.
Go house to house and see what you come up with.
Footprint.
What can you tell me about the shoe prints?
Men's size 8s. Pinker lifted impressions for me to compare back at the lab.
Cause of death?
It could be the head injuries. She has been badly stomped. The cuts look superficial. I'll know for sure.
What caused the blunt force injury to the face?
Could be anything from a baseball bat to a lug wrench. I'll have more details after the autopsy.
Brutal way to go.
Interesting.
Nothing there.
What about this wound on the finger?
Something removed, a ring most likely. I assume it was taken post-mortem.
What's the writing on the victim mean?
BD, like Dahlia, Tex. Your guess is as good as mine. Could be something to it, or it could be the killers trying to throw you off the scent. Either way, I'll run tests on the lipstick.
Any idea of the time of death?
From the temperature, I'd say after midnight. I'll confirm with you later.
Victim's bag? Looks brand new. Can't be the one used on the body.
Nope. And this is just a random hairbrush.
Like some kind of puzzle or parlor game.
There we go. Pretty simple.
Bomba Club. Why steal a table lighter?
Why indeed?
When we get to the Bomba, a man could die of thirst in a case like this.
Well, I guess we're done because Russ is running off. Club then. It's the only lead we've got.
The werewolf?
For my money, copycat.
We can't rule it out. We need to work the evidence.
You'd love that, wouldn't you? A big head to hang on your wall. The caller of the decade. I've been working evidence on BD case for 6 months and got nicks.
There's a difference, Rusty.
Oh, yeah?
I just started working it today.
Okay, Oddshot. What's more likely? The werewolf comes back around, leaving us a note on the corpse?
He clearly has a thing for power. Power over women. Watch.
Watch where you're driving, you maniac!
Finished, fellas. A guy opened his mouth like a 6 month storm. A some opportunist who's been reading about the BD figures, he'll rip off the MO and get himself a freebie.
That's not totally fantastical.
You know, the Examiner of the Daily News might be good at coming up with monikers, but they're terrible for police work. There's a reason we didn't get the son of a bitch after the short murder. It was them, locusts.
Where do you think the werewolf killer is now?
Dead by his own hand, stationed somewhere else with the armed forces. San Quentin, another town, another country, who knows? So, Phillips, I understand you want to turn this into a big case, but it doesn't work like that, all right? A case will come and find you. You can't make it something it ain't. Understand?
So you don't think the werewolf has continued to operate in the Los Angeles area?
No chance. You would have found it.
Could easily have hidden the bodies rather well. Or he doesn't notice that you've got an extra bunch of killings by him. Here we are. Let's see if anyone saw the victim.
Gentlemen, what can I get you?
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. Were you working here last night?
Yes. How can I help, officer?
You can start with your name.
Garrett Mason.
You're the regular bartender on nights?
I'm a temporary barman. I work for an agency. I fill in at bars across town.
Do you remember a woman who came in here last night? 5'7", about 110 pounds, blonde hair, about 40 years of age.
You mean Celine Henry?
Yes. Do you know anything about her?
I don't. But the owner, Mr. McCall, serves her most nights. Would you like to speak to him?
I would.
He sits at the back of the club. Wears a hibiscus. You can't miss it. Is there anything else?
Fire away, Phelps. I'll stay here in my little parched. Pour me three fingers of rye.
Wow, you're lazy.
You ought to meet Joe's buddy. He's nice.
Detective Phelps, LAPD. We're investigating the murder of Celine Henry. Do you know her?
Celine? Christ. Sure I know her. She and I and Jacob, her husband, we go way back.
She was here last night?
Sure, she's a regular. Celine is...
House officer.
Was
a...
lovely woman.
Was Mrs. Henry here with anyone last night?
Not at first. Celine already had quite a head start.
But she attracted attention?
Certainly. A few gentlemen became very enamored with her and her stories. One guy in particular.
You know him?
No. He's been in a couple of times.
Did they leave together?
Yes. At around 11. If it helps, I made the guy's license plate.
Well, that'll be helpful. 2B8899.
I think this could be a great help, sir. Thank you. Mrs. Henry appeared to be missing a ring, torn from her finger, but not her wedding finger.
Celine always wore a red garnet ring on the large side. Larger than life, like Celine herself.
Did she have it a long time?
Sure. Since way back in her flying days.
Did her husband buy it for her?
No, it was before Jacob.
I think you know where the ring came from, and I think you're gonna tell me.
Okay. I bought it years ago. I carried a torch for Celine in those days. Yes, I always have. Her old man never knew about it.
You know the husband?
Sure I know Jacob. He was in the Corps. He met Celine on a furlough and married her when the war was finished. Put up with a load of shit.
Do you think he killed his wife?
No. No, not in my opinion.
I don't know about this one. Use intuition.
So if it wasn't Jacob, then you probably let her out of here with the guy who killed her. How do you feel about that?
Stole the attitude, will you? I tried to get onto Jacob. I rang him up. Asked him to come pick her up, like usual. But he refused. And she picked some night to push him over the edge. I rang him back around 11:30, but got no answer.
Yeah, you got all free, right?
You've been a big help. One more thing. Would you have an address for Celine?
142 North Union Avenue. God knows I had to send her home in enough cabs to remember that.
Right, let's go to her house. We need to ring up first.
Where's that?
Let's get out of here.
Hey, what's the hurry? My stool was just starting to warm up nicely.
Operator, give me R&I.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need a registered owner on a license plate, 2BOY8899.
Yes, Detective. I'll need to contact the DMV. Shall I relay the details via KGPL?
Please. Thanks for your help.
Right, let's get going. Oopsie daisy. Let's go.
Slow and steady, come on!
Hey, I was backing out, so
sharp as my investigatory instincts.
A smart lawyer might use that to throw out anything you collect today.
A smart man might know it's unwise to stand between the patient and his medicine.
As long as you're not falling over, Rusty, I'll let it slide.
That's mighty kind of you, Phelps. You know, you picked the wrong job in the hearty first place.
We owe it to this city to do the best we can in this position. As homicide detectives, that responsibility is all the more serious.
Always the politician.
It's not political, it's practical. Maybe the men combing Hollywood Boulevard after the Elizabeth Short murder were more interested in sniffing out booze than the clues that would have led to her killer.
Yeah, well, if only you'd been there, choir boy. Betty Short would be alive, the Japs would have spared Pearl Harbor, our ancestors wouldn't have tasted the forbidden fruit.
Minor syntactical error, Detective Galloway. I never claimed to be able to prevent crimes. I only suggested a proficiency in solving them.
Well, can't get
that's
it through
the
there.
Drink slowing you down.
Oh, my God, brother, oh, brother. Worse than I could ever have imagined.
I think parts of this game are locked off, well, map-wise, until later parts of the game. Either that or they're just not built. A little faster than the one we had last time, but not by much. Certainly a tough one, though.
God, you're gonna kill us!
My driving isn't up to scratch today. Right, let's see what this place holds. Somebody's already been here.
Side window's been jimmied. Looks like somebody's creeped the joint.
Oh, got some backstory here.
You said I had to go back, Doctor.
Fires are cathartic. They allow you to confront your past.
You said the house would be empty.
Are you taking the medication I have prescribed?
You said the house would be empty. I heard them screaming.
Circumstances were unfortunate. My colleagues had made all the necessary arrangements.
You said the house would be empty. You're killing me.
The deaths were unfortunate. But you have dealt with death before.
I want you to come to the clinic and we can deal with it.
You said the house would be empty! How can I find peace?
That doctor is an arsehole.
This is going to help us.
A key. A useless key.
Size nines. Above average for a lady.
Indeed.
Burglar used a pry bar. Why did you kick the door in?
You think I'm gonna climb through a broken window in a $30 suit? You got another thing coming, Buster.
Oh, $30. Wow.
Selene and Jacob are obviously having problems. It speaks to motive.
Crime scene evidence still weighs against it being a husband. Jacob could give us something to go on. One of my F's drank like this, you'd be feeling the back of my hand.
Call in burglary and get technical services out here. I'll talk to the neighbors.
Don't take all day about it, Phelps. I'll get nasty when I'm thirsty.
Tiffany, where's the stuff is junk? Might explain the missing ring.
Request technical services for a suspected 459 at 142 North Union.
A regular Amelia Earhart per day. The ring looks distinct.
Well, if anyone tries to sell it, surely be able to find it. Let's go see if the neighbors know anything. Come here, lady.
LAPD, are you acquainted with Celine Henry, Miss...
Horgan! Jennifer Horgan. I've known Celine for more than 10 years. Our children grew up together. What's going on, officer?
Did you see Mrs. Henry go out last night?
Well, I'm no busybody, you understand, but Celine had been drinking. And she and poor, long-suffering Jacob had a terrible row. I think Jacob may have given her a black eye. He stormed out and she went back inside.
Did he come back?
No. Celine was listening to music and shouting until she left around 10 p.m. She was very drunk to have been driving. But she is not the sort of person you can stop from doing something when her dander is up. What is this about, officer? Is Celine all right?
I'm afraid Mrs. Henry has been murdered, ma'am.
Murdered? Oh, my God. I'm afraid I need to go and then sit down.
You do that. All right, let's go find Jacob.
Let's see what Jacob has to say for himself.
I don't think Jacob is our man, but we should see what he has to say.
Jacob Henry.
Just go easy, Phelps.
Jacob Henry had a violent argument with his wife last night. He's looking more and more likely.
For my money, the broad keeps the house looking like that, so probably deserved it. The skipper says bring him in and keep the hacks off our backs for a while.
Fine by me.
So it ain't the werewolf killer after all. Good to see you've come to your senses, Cole.
I always said work the evidence. I only stipulated a connection to the BD killer as an avenue of investigation we should leave open. And as far as I'm concerned, it still is.
Let's take a shortcut. Alright, let's see if he's here.
Okay, Phelps, we go in hard. You follow my lead.
Go on then. If you wanna go, you go first.
You Jacob Henry?
Yeah. Who's asking?
LAPD. You're under arrest for the murder of your wife, Celine Henry.
Murder? Celine?
Save the dramatics RKO, pal. You got bigger problems.
What the hell are you talking about? You come in here, you tell me that Celine is...
Take a seat, Mr. Henry. We're going to have a look around, then we'll talk.
Jesus. I'm sorry.
What have we got around here, then?
Oldest problem there is, what to do about the old lady.
He'll be back in.
What size boots are you, mister? Well, too big for the crime scene.
Size 11s.
Doesn't mean that he got someone else to do it, though.
So who could have killed Celine? Where did she go last night, Jacob?
A bar, I suppose. Look, I don't know.
We know that she drinks, Jacob. Drunks have regular haunts, places they feel relaxed.
Celine did most of her drinking at home. She didn't have many friends left. Not many alcoholics do. Real friends, anyway.
Damn, got that one wrong.
When did you last see your wife, Mr. Henry?
Last night. I went to see her. We talked. Things got a little out of hand. I left.
You don't remember what time you last saw your wife alive?
Look, I'm sorry. I left. Maybe 9 p.m. Might have been a little later, but right around 9.
Why did you kill her, Jacob? Things will go better if you come clean about it.
That's a lousy thing to say. I never gave up on my wife.
I don't believe you, Jacob. I think you didn't have the guts to do it yourself, so you had someone else do it.
You want to back that up with something, Big Mouth?
Yeah. Huh?
The note by the phone suggests you meant her harm.
You want the truth? Truth is, I was sick to death of her. I was trying to have her committed.
So you can prove that you came back here after you left your wife's place.
I came back here. I was here all night. Start work at 6:30. I'm not the going out type.
Use intuition on this one. Don't want to get another one wrong.
Did a neighbor see you? Did you talk to anyone? You need an alibi, Jacob.
I don't have one. I was here. I listened to Amos and Andy on the radio, and then I went to bed.
We're still going to need you to come downtown, Mr. Henry.
We can get this all down on paper, Jacob. How you got fed up with your wife and how you figured killing her would bury all your troubles.
Kill my own wife?
She was a lush and a tramp, and you just couldn't stand it anymore.
Shut your goddamn mouth.
So now you're going to tell me you loved her? Ah, the DA goes all gooey over remorse, Jacob.
Oh, dear.
You're not... being
okay. Let's listen to that.
Doesn't look good for you, Jacob.
What's this bunkum?
Call it in and get a squad car dispatched. And check for messages. I'll keep old Slugger here company.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need a patrol unit to transport a suspect back to Central.
Certainly, Detective. You have a message from the coroner. Do you wish to be put through?
Yes, ma'am.
Carruthers.
It's Phelps.
I've completed the autopsy. Several wounds to the head from a blunt metal instrument. Closest match would be a socket wrench handle.
So the cause of death was the blunt...
No, the blows to the head surprisingly were not fatal. Death was from hemorrhage and shock from the fractured ribs and multiple injuries caused by the stomping.
Anything else?
He's some kind of sex fiend. The tissues of the anus were bruised about 1/8 of an inch. No trace of semen in the anus, vagina, or stomach.
Thanks, Doc. Operator, give me R&I. Any word on an owner for that vehicle? License was 2BOY8899?
Yes, Detective. The plate belongs to a brown 1936 Pontiac. Registered owner is one Alonzo Mendez of 402 South Fremont Street, apartment 16.
Thanks.
That's helpful.
Any other messages?
One, Detective. From Captain Donnelly. He wants any and all suspects returned to Central. Interviews to be set up immediately.
Got it. We're coming in.
I think we'll interrogate this guy a bit more first.
Brother said she took a real pounding.
Maybe if he had been a little firmer in the beginning, he wouldn't be in this situation now.
Oh, bit of lag. Don't do this to me. See, I do apologize about the weird edit there, but the game randomly crashed on me.
Brother said she took a real pounding.
Maybe if he had been a little firmer in the beginning, he wouldn't be in this situation now.
I imagine that Neanderthal routine is a big hit with the ladies, Galloway.
Women love me, Phelps. I have no complexity. They know exactly what they're going to get.
Thank you.
survive this, it's gonna be a miracle.
Alright, let's see what else we can get out of Jacob.
We have a firm lead, Captain.
Are you questioning my judgment, Cole Phelps?
No, sir.
Good. I thought not. Jacob Henry is a sub-sister pushed around by his wife. I think with the right kind of persuasion, he might be prepared to seek absolution. Are you prepared to show him the error of his ways, young Phelps?
I don't think he's our man. Galloway agrees with me.
Don't drag me into this.
Rusty is a practical policeman. A bird in hand is always worth two in the bush. Let's liberate a confession from poor Jacob and the public will sleep easier tonight. Run along now, folks. I've warmed them up nicely for you.
Yeah, the bum took a swipe at me. Put him down with my sap.
Doesn't look good, Jacob. You're in a big jam here. You lie to me and I can't help you out. Do you understand me?
Yes.
What do you do for work, Jacob?
I'm a mechanic. Engines, differentials, transmissions, that kind of stuff.
So you have access to tools?
Yes, I do.
Your wife was brutally beaten with a socket wrench handle, then stomped to death. How do you think that looks, Jacob?
I was home in bed.
Full of shit, Jacob. The truth is you hated that bitch. You followed her and dragged her into the car and then took her out to the moors. She woke up and you smashed her face in with a socket.
No. No, 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 no.
And then you stomped her. You stomped her because she's a drunken whore and she treated you like shit. You stomped her for all the years you had to take it. You stomped her because you are such a weak fucking sister, Jacob, and you wanted to erase all memory of it. Go on. Try to deny it.
I was at home. I should have gone to her at the bar, but I didn't. You can't prove I wasn't home.
I can. The bar owner, McCall, gave you up. He called your house right at the time that someone was smashing Celine's skull in and got no answer. If we find that socket wrench, you're gonna fry. Get it off your chest. Tell me you killed her.
I killed her, all right. I killed her dreams. She was an aviator. Famous in her day, flying around up there like a bird. But she never wanted to come back down. You know, my pop was a sod farmer, dirt poor. I joined the Corps, trained to be a mechanic. I did better than my father did. I worked hard for it. It's all you can ask of a man. Celine. She never wanted to come down from the clouds. She wanted everything I couldn't give her. All I had was security. That was never going to be enough.
You did it. Everything points to you. What does Tex mean, Jacob?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I need a reason to believe you, Jacob.
You want a confession? That's what you want?
That's exactly what we want.
Seems to me there are two types of marriages. First, where the couple love each other equally and everything's roses. And then there's the other, where one person loves the other more than life itself and always puts them first. Chumps like me, who love them no matter what, no matter how badly they behave. That's it. That's my confession. I love my wife. And I'll take any test you got to prove it.
Your marriage was over. You took her in and she threw it back in your face. You didn't go over there to hurt her. It just got out of hand.
It's not how it was.
I haven't used a lot of intuition on this one.
You're lying, Jacob. It was falling apart and things got violent.
I'm not lying. I'm telling you how it was.
Jenny Horgan says you blackened her eye.
It's all right, Jacob. The DA will understand. In your shoes, I would have done exactly the same thing.
I hit her, all right? I'm not proud of it, but she was coming at me with a frying pan. What would you do? I took it for years, but sometimes a man can only take so much.
Why did you break into your wife's house, Jacob? Why steal the ring?
What? What are you talking about? I've got a key. Why would I need to break in?
You took the ring because you found out who gave it to her.
What are you talking about?
Her prized garnet ring, given to her by her old boyfriend, Dick McCall.
I never knew that. I lived with that woman for 3 years, and I never knew that. In that case, I think you should be talking to Dick McCall.
We'll do the detective work, Lunkhead. Just answer the questions.
I'll see what I can do for you, Jacob. But I'm not promising. It still looks bad for you.
Like, all right.
Phelps, you failed me something.
We have another lead, Captain. This guy Mendez could be our man.
I hope so, Phelps. I really hope so. I'm deeply disturbed by your style of police work.
What, the right way? Alright, let's go find Mendez.
Hey.
You're gonna kill us!
No, I'm not. It's fine. This car is a tank. Even likes to fly a little bit when you get it going.
Get the point.
Alonzo Mendez. Sound like a man who moonlights as the werewolf?
Don't sound like a man I'd let my daughter
in. You've got a daughter.
Spend enough time drinking, Cole, you'll find yourself with any number of things you don't want. You're sober.
So that's why you never sober up.
Exactly.
Alright, nearly there.
Mendez, apartment 16.
Top floor.
Here, the apartment's up on the top floor.
Knock and just kick the door in. Take a look around and see what you can find.
Just some eggs. Tea. Coffee. A gun.
Junk.
Well, not really. It's still a gun. Size shoes are you? 8s.
Gotta get these to Ray. Size 8s could help place Mendez at the scene.
Pretty dirty as well. Well, this is convincing.
Brothers could match the color and brand of the body.
There's a lot of evidence here.
Consistent with Celine's injuries, and the blood can be typed.
We have the murder weapon. We better get Pinker down here.
Why keep it? Why not throw it away?
Think these clowns are geniuses? Thank your stars you caught a break. Captain Donald would begin to like you.
Hey! What gives? LAPD, you're under arrest.
Yeah, run away,
also. Do not
lose
that son of a bitch. I'll go get our wheels. Mendez, stop right there!
Unfortunately, I remember this bit. And there's a glitch, so if I don't do the right thing, or a weird thing, or whatever.
You don't need to do this, Alonzo!
That's why. It's a glitch that I specifically remember because it annoyed the hell out of me when I originally played it. I doubt it's been fixed. And I'm not risking it, because I can't watch. So basically, can't never get inside the car. This never works for some reason, so I'm gonna leg it over to this one over here and get in this one instead. So this one's pretty fast. Gaining. Ram him. Rah. Come on, speed. Come on. Slowest speed chase ever. Oh shit. Train. Oh crap.
Not good.
Of course it's not good. There's car parts littered all over
the place.
Murder
of Celine Henry.
Show me your hands.
Well, that's pretty intense. Yeah, specifically remember that glitch. He can never let you inside the car that Rusty's in for some reason.
I ain't saying a goddamn thing.
You don't need to. The evidence is overwhelming, Sunshine.
You did a grand job, lads. Phelps. That's quite a way to acquit yourself in your first outing as a homicide investigator. It seems the city has a new and vengeful guardian. Considering the evidence against your suspect and the thoroughness with which your report was compiled, I foresee a safe passage through the courts, and the DA agrees with me. Brutality on a scale such as this deserves retribution. The people and the press of this city demand.
Well and truly left out. So see how we did. Got all of the clues. Got 9 of the 11 questions right, so that's better than the last time. But a fair bit of vehicle damage. But we only got 3 stars as a result of that. But yeah, sorry about the game crashing halfway through there. But at least we we're at a good save point. So yeah, case closed. So let's move on to the next case.